Yet to hey, tribal members. I am Ryan Little Eagle Pierce, Opelanyatet. I'm a member of the Nanakoke Lenni Lenape tribe and founder and artistic director of Eagle Project, an intertribal and multicultural performing arts company fiscally sponsored by New York Live Arts. It is our goal to explore the American identity so that we as Americans can have a more accurate recollection of our past, a better understanding of our present, for a just and more inclusive vision for our future. Over the past 4 years, we at Eagle Project have had the privilege of collaborating with and being hosted by the Public Theater, the Lark Play Development Center, Primary Stages, as well as the United Nations. As we enter our fifth year, we are eagerly raising funds for our fourth full production, Lost Voices. The two one-act plays that make up Lost Voices will explore two different ethnic groups who were greatly affected by Hurricane Katrina and who, because of their economic status in our society, have been almost lost in our consciousness. Vanishing Point is a new work written by Lakota playwright Larissa Fasthorse. Inspired by the Biloxi Choctaw tribe, America's first official climate refugees, Vanishing Point follows two characters who fight to stay above water in Louisiana. If they can just weather the storm, they will survive. But what if the storm never ends and the water never retreats? Will saving themselves mean the loss of their entire tribe? The second play, Wide Blossoms, by Elise Marinson, deals with a young white lawyer in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Having escaped from New Orleans after the storm, the lawyer is in a bar drinking his sorrows away after work late one night. A young African-American woman enters the bar disheveled, and throughout the play she drops phrases, songs, and poems that haunt the lawyer. She almost seems like a ghost or our conscience picking away at something that we're trying to cover up. Once the dramatic truth is revealed, we are once again reminded that in the end, we are all connected to one another. Lost Voices brings to the surface the American secrets and realities that Hurricane Katrina uncovered, and the uncomfortable truths left in the residue. Whether one lives in Louisiana, Florida, California, Manhattan Island, or any of the areas in between, Lost Voices drives home the reality that how we treat one another and our planet are interconnected. Will we choose to listen to what Mother Nature sent us? The choice is ours, and time is running out. Please help give these community stories a platform by making a contribution today. While much may have already been lost, we can still act now to preserve what's left. Wanishi, thank you for your time.